the Three Little Pigs homes. Well, you know the story, don't you? Who's afraid of the big bad wolf?
Looks like Big Bad's already blown down the houses of straw and sticks. Brick's the only one left.
We should look inside. Remember Joss's words?
Mm-hmm. One bean lies out in the open, guarded by three nobodies. Yeah, could be it.
Thank you.
The big bad Witcher huffed and puffed, and look, got a bean.
It cannot be.
What cannot be?
You actually have a sense of humor.
Why so shocked?
Well, when you arrived, all you did was pout and mumble things in that gruffly monotone. And now this. A jest. And a good one at that. But here we are chatting away when there's work to do. We must keep looking. So, do you like it here?
No. Got a problem with magic in general. Illusions, portals, all that. Don't trust any of it.
A bow of old-fashioned tastes, eh? I like that.
Such exquisite roads, the world never seen.
Watch out, pixies!
This Longlock's tower?
Indeed. It's even taller than I remember.
Wait. What Joss said about the third beam, remember?
In the possession of a bald farmhand somewhere deep beneath the ground. Yes, this must be it. Let's go. It always grapple up her braid in the past, but I don't see it anywhere.
We'll find another way up. Could pull myself up here, and I'll have to make that jump.
If you say so, I shall wait down here if it's all the same. Climbing's not my strong suit. Ah!
Prince's corpse. Tried to free Longlocks, but fell and broke his neck. have stunk to climb all that way for nothing.
So?
Got the beam, but long locks. Seems she got sick of waiting for a knight in shining armor.
Can you blame her? Men these days, dandies and fops all.
That why you cozied up to a vampire?
Detlaf was a tool, and only a tool.
Too bad he didn't know that.
I trust no one. Learned that long ago. Now it's his turn.
To use him. Was that your plan from the start?
No. At first, I was simply intrigued. Do you know the story? It was in Matina, a few years past. I'd gone there to pass some loot off to a fence I know. We were hashing out the terms when in walked Detlaf. He said he'd come to sell a silver candlestick. He gripped it through a cloth. That caught my eye. I followed him out, observed him from a distance. But he caught on quickly.
Yeah, superhuman senses will do that.
He turned down a blind alley. I followed. He jumped out from behind a crate, baring his teeth. I suppose he'd wanted to frighten me. Alas, he didn't in the least. After all, I'm a monster too, am I not?
A higher vampire and you were unimpressed? Don't know if that's brave or just plain foolish.
I've always had a way with ostensibly dangerous, quiet types.
That's supposed to be about me, too?
Ugh, brother, I hate to disappoint you, Geralt, but your belly button is not the center of the known world. Though, you do remind me of him a bit, stifling all emotions inside you, ever feigning indifference. You see, when I met Detlaf, somehow I knew, call it intuition, that he meant me no harm. That he was trying to frighten me off, for he, too, was scared. Now do you understand?
I guess. What happened then?
We talked, then met up once, twice, three times. Enough that he became infatuated. I truly enjoyed it at first, but only at first. He did not love like a man. But like an animal, madly, deeply, unconditionally, wildly. To return such a feeling, anyone would be hard-pressed. Let alone someone as twisted as I am.
So there came a day you just up and disappeared?
Yes. There was no other way. Let's just be friends, or I don't deserve you. He'd never have understood that sort of thing. But then, once I decided to return, clean up some old affairs, I remembered him, and concluded he could still be of use.
Playing with fire, that.
Definitely. And either I'll get burned, or I'll burn all else down. No other options.
Got a history with Detlaf now. So this meeting will be different. Not afraid?
I can handle him.
Mm-hmm. Sure about that?
You look at him as a witcher and see a monster. I know what he's really like. You needn't worry. It's time to go. Just a bit more work and we'll be able to say sot off to this fecking fable sphere. Now we must plant them by the path near Longlock's tower, then prepare to meet the giant.
Care for a cigarillo? A bit of tobacco? A dab of Fistech?
Remind me, what tale are you from?
Sold flints when I was a lass, but no one bought them, so I branched out. Now I deal in snuffs, puffs, all sorts of fun things. What'll you have, sweeties?
Nothing. We just want to get out of here, as fast as we can.
Sweet cheeks. Two puffs of my stuff, and I guarantee you'll fly out of here as if...
Hey, where'd you get that ribbon? That's mine.
Is that so? Then why was it lying in the bushes? Finders keepers, sweetheart.
The ribbon. Mind explaining what the fuss is about?
There's not much to explain. I got it from Aturius Vigo when I was a child. It was to protect me from evil. It clearly didn't work, given how I ended up.
But it means a lot to you.
How should I put this? I have so few mementos from my childhood, and the ribbon reminds me of the good old days, when I was someone else.
Dears, could you continue this touching scene elsewhere, You're scaring away my customers.
Give Sienna the ribbon. Why not, huh?
Sugar Plum. The only thing I hand out for free is a first hit. To get them to come back for a second, of course. For all else, you've got to pay.
What if I asked you nicely?
Ask me nicely and I might play you for it. A round of cards?
All right, let's play. If you lose, you give me the ribbon.
Don't get your hopes up. None can best me at Gwent. Good at this. A word to our skiffin. The ribbon's yours. Now skedaddle.
All right. Tell me.
What?
What you want in return. You're not doing this out of the kindness of your heart.
Don't want anything in return.
Thank you.